Not long. Oh! Oh! Not long! Put my suit and my skirt away, and pray for God's guidance every hour. If I am wanted, say I've gone to offer my last few coins to the inmates of the prison.
Vintage, Tachi.
Oh, and what do you want,
huh? I want a message from...
Ah, please, before you go on, take this.
What?
Cover that bosom. I'm not meant to see you. Things like that. Kindly moderate your language. I shall have to withdraw. May he grant you all the joy that I, his humble servant, also wish for you.
Thank you for those kind thoughts. Shall we make ourselves more comfortable?
Are you feeling any better?
Much, thank you.
My humble prayers, I'm afraid, wouldn't have done all I'd have wished to obtain this happy outcome. Please know that I prayed for you day and night.
Oh, you shouldn't have.
No! Nothing is more dear to me than your health. If it could help, I'd gladly give you mine.
Very Christian of you, I'm sure. But thank you, no.
I'd love to help you more.
I wanted to work with you, and now seems a good time. No one's around.
I too am glad it's where I alone. It's what I hoped and prayed for, and now at last, God has helped me.
Can we be frank? May we lay our cards on the table?
The one favour I ask everyone is to let me bear my heart to you. Please believe that the objections I have raised about the visitors you attract here were not made in any spirit of rage or scorn, but rather by a pure, intense concern for the state of your...
My soul, I know.
Indeed, Lee. So intense that
ouch.
Oh, a thousand pardons! I will never hurt you! It's my deep interest in...
What's that in?
Feelings of fabric. Soft!
Please don't, I'm ticklish.
Oh, Evonne, what fabulous lace! The male clothes they do these days! I've never seen such fine work!
Yeah. Can we get to the point? It seems my husband has gone back on his word and now wants you for his son-in-law. Am I wrong?
He has mentioned it. Although, to be honest, that's not the happiness I long for. No. The perfect ecstasy I crave lies somewhere else.
You mean life everlasting?
I had in mind here and now.
You surprise me. I assumed you were a zap out of our world of imperfection.
Heavenly beauty and one more down to earth aren't mutually exclusive. One can love both, since God made both. Their perfections quite devastates the senses. Whenever I behold you, perfect creature, I see the maker I worship. My heart swells with love, gazing upon God's perfect self-portrait. At first, I was fearful that the secret glow was the devil trying to trip me up. I resolved to keep away, worried you might lead me down the slippery slope. Huh? I prayed, I wept,
I fasted.
To no avail. But you know this. You see now I look at you and sigh. Oui, madame. I'll lay my cards on the table. Oh, can't you look kindly on this lecture? Upon your unworthy slave, writhing in agony at your feet. Oh, you creature from heaven, be the temple that I worship. I can guarantee complete discretion. You have nothing to fear on my account. Your honor is safe with me. Not like those loudmouths at court for their stupid wives who shut their happy exploits on the rooftops. People like us are different. Passion, bound, undercover, hidden from you. By watching our own reputations, we safeguard the lady's good name. Those who accept our offer enjoy love without scandal, pleasure without fear.
Your language leaves no room for ambiguity. Hasn't it occurred to you that I might tell my husband what you really want? This sudden revelation could change his opinion of you.
I know you wouldn't be that cruel.
Okay, I shall be discreet. However, something in return. Valet. Marianne. You must do all you can in trying to make it happen. You must relinquish all claims which by rights belong to someone else.
No! This must be made public. I was there. I heard everything. And now I can expose this traitor.
Oh, dummies. This must go no further. Let Tartuffe mend his ways to